Welcome to the Friday, August 15th, 2014 edition of Erner Barra's Daily Video, sponsored by Ipsano's Market Insight Report. In today's show, grocers may be poised to feature more pork this fall. And later, we analyze the market implications of Russia's import ban on U.S. poultry. But first, the USDA has stepped up its ground beef traceability program. Here with the story is your host, Nicole Bessemer.
The USDA's Food Safety and Inspection Service announced new procedures that will allow the agency to trace contaminated ground beef back to its source more quickly, remove it from commerce, and identify the root cause to prevent it from happening again. Under the Inspection Service's changes, immediate regulatory action will be taken on ground beef that tests positive for E. coli or is otherwise contaminated. This eliminates the agency's need to wait 2 days for a confirmation test before any action is taken. Another rule change will also allow the Inspection Service to take immediate action on those supplying contaminated products. This is in stark contrast to the 30-day waiting period used to conduct a food safety assessment of a supplier's slaughter establishment. The USDA said it will fully implement the changes by October 14th. Subscribers can get full details on the revamped ground beef inspection program, along with other news out of the USDA, by logging into foodmarket.com. In other news, falling prices could have retailers turn to pork for their fall protein promotions. Here is pork market reporter Russell Barton with the story.
A steep slide in wholesale pork prices may lead to wider options for retailers and consumers in September. With only 2.5 weeks remaining in August, it's too late for the supermarket chains to take advantage of the lower pork prices and plug more or different items into their Labor Day promotions. However, according to Erner Barry Newswire's Kurt Thacker, some grocers could look to mid-September to begin promoting more pork chops, shoulder steaks, and spare ribs for late-season grilling events. Wholesale pork prices based on Erner Barry's pork carcass cutout value fell 6.5% by the middle of the week. During the same period, USDA's pork carcass composite value for FOB Omaha fell 8.3%. The latest quotes were down more than $20 per hundredweight, or about 15% and 17% respectively, from the all-time highs hit in mid-July. Thacker said seasonal expansion in hog supplies, along with continued record high average carcass weights, are contributing to the decline in wholesale pork prices, even though the week's slaughter is projected to be down nearly 8% from a year ago. This week's hog slaughter is expected to be about 2.15 million head, the highest since early May and up from the average of about 1.857 million head that occurred during the non-holiday weeks of July. Get more weekly retail feature updates from the pork and other protein industries by checking our Erner Barry's weekly retail summary under any of the protein tabs in Comto.
Thanks, Russell. Here to wrap up today's report is account manager Adam Sharkey with an analysis of how Russia's import ban on the U.S. poultry could impact the chicken market.
Though much of the conversation in the poultry industry has been on the possible impact of the Russian ban on imports from the U.S., it remains to be seen whether there will be an adverse effect on market prices. Throughout much of the 2000s, Erner Barry's leg quarter quotation fluctuated in a manner consistent with import volume to Russia. In recent years, leg quarter values have maintained normal trading levels and have done so even without the support of Russian buying power at its previous pace. Erner Barry's quotation has already been downwardly adjusted, but there is little evidence to suggest that an aggressive correction is on the horizon. Over the next several weeks, sellers will be canvassing the export markets in search of outlets for their upcoming product, and it is even likely that they will explore domestic retail as a possibility. The effect of these shifts will certainly affect someone's bottom line, but we'll have to see whether it's that of the buyer or the seller.
Thanks, Adam. That concludes our program for the week. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you on Monday.
Today's video is sponsored by Ipsano's Market Insight for the meat industry, providing information, education, and insight for the beef, pork, and poultry industries. View a sample report at Ipsano.com or call 800-932-0617 to get your free sample today.